Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you've been following along, you've been seeing that I've been learning how to disassemble this S54 engine. Now I'm going to be starting assembling it again. So as you can see, I have the block here. It is cleaned, we've wiped it all down. It is ready to go, but I'm gonna just tell you what parts we're gonna be using. They're my favorite parts, if you know me. We're gonna be using MAHLE PowerPak Pistons, as well as the Carrillo rods with the WNC bolts, and then main ACL bearings, as well as King rod bearings. So first start off, I'm gonna be putting in the oil squirters, which I have here. But first things first, I'm going to be putting my hair up because I cannot work with my hair down and get all sweaty and have it in my face. Now that my hair's up, I'm gonna put some gloves on and we are going to get into it. So far in this building process, well, learning how to disassemble and building, it has been fairly simple. I've had a lot of questions. Obviously, as you know, we sell parts. So I know a lot of the parts. It's just now it's good to learn where all these parts go specifically and seeing it. Sorry, my hands are really sweaty. So that one's on. Just wanna make sure I grab it all properly. So like I was saying, it is really nice to see where all these parts go, how they work together. And it's honestly been fun learning how to do this. I've always wanted to learn how to do this. I find it very interesting and very soothing to assemble things together. So without further ado, let's get into it. I'm going to take my bolts here and I'm going to put a little bit of Loctite on them, just a little dibby dab. Oop, dropped it out. Like you see a little dibby dab. I'm gonna take my oil squirter, put it in here. I'm gonna take my 1/4 inch, put that in here. I'm gonna put this hand tight for now. Okay, that one's hand tight. I'm gonna go on to the next one and repeat all the way down the line. Another little dibby dab. Another oil squirter. Grab this. Bolts. Okay, and last one. Okay, so now that they're all hand tight, I'm gonna take my digital torque wrench, turn it on. So if you follow the spec sheet will tell you from BMW that it needs to be 10 Newton meters. If you look here, and 10 Newton meters converts to 7.3 foot pounds. So I already have it at 7 foot pounds. So I'm just gonna go a little over to make sure I get 7.3. So let me grab this. Okay. So once I get to 7, it beeps and vibrates, but then I'm looking for 7.3. Good. And I let go. I just hold it for a few seconds and then let it go. So I'm just going to do this again. And good. Now all the oil squirters are torqued down. So next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to be putting in the ACL main bearings. As you can see, one's already in and it's lubed up. So these come written on the bearings, if you didn't already know this. Let me pull one out so you guys could see. So these have, it's very hard to see, you have to like put in the light correctly, an indication here that shows U for upper. So these are the upper ones. And then this one says L, which is for lower. And being that the block is flipped upside down right now, we're going to be using the upper ones to put in first. So I'm going to take this. And there's also another indication of how to put this in. There's a little groove right here on the bearing. That is going to align with this piece right here. If you can see in the block, all the way through. So I'm just going to put this one in. You just need a little pressure. You don't need much. And you know when you put it in properly, because you should be able to see on this, my left hand, which would be your right hand side, the holes line up on the inside here. So then from here, I'm just going to put all of them in and then I'll lube them all up together. So let me finish putting them through. So again, just making sure this shows upper. Just gonna pop a squat so I can see that they are leveled. And just press firmly down to make sure it is lined up. You will have a little wiggle room if you like feel it, like you'll have a little wiggle room, but you won't have much, so you shouldn't need too much force to put these in. Okay, I'm gonna skip this one for now and go straight to the last one. Again, just making sure they line up. Push down. Okay, so as you can see, if you look through, you'll see all the holes are lined up. And then last but not least, this is the thrust bearing, so it's a bit bigger. Make sure again this lines up with the notch there. And this one is going to go right in like that. And you should see this one feels a little bit easier to push in because it's a little bit bigger. And as you can see, the hole lines up again. So the last thing I'm going to do is be very liberal with my assembly loop. As you can see, there's already some in this one. So and you're just gonna rubber all in. Let me wipe that away. And you're just going to go down the line in the same steps. And then the same thing. Rubber all in. So one of the things I've learned in this process is you have to be very patient. And if you know me, I'm not that patient, but like I said, this is one of those soothing things for me that I really enjoy, or seem that I would like to enjoy. So.
Hey.
This bottle is very difficult to squeeze. And last one. And there you have it. All of the upper bearings are lubed up right now. And next thing we will be doing is putting the crankshaft in and then dropping a couple pistons and rods in. So let's keep it going. All right, so now that we have the oil squirters torqued down, as well as the upper main bearings in, lubed up, ready to go, I'm going to have one of my guys help me put the crankshaft in so that we can put on the lower bearing, main bearing, and the main caps and torque them down as well. So I'm gonna go get the crankshaft and put it in. All right, so now that you can see we have the crankshaft in, I just want you guys to come over so you can see as I spin the crank that everything is lined up and it's spinning smoothly. As you can see, some of the lube is already on part of it. So now I'm going to put in the lower caps now with the lower bearings with the caps. I'm just going to be using the old main cap bolts just to line them up and make sure that they're seated properly. You don't want to do this with the new ones because they'll just end up stretching and you don't want to do that. You'll waste bolts basically at this point. And basically what I'm going to do is I'm just going to hand tighten them, not super forceful. Let's get into it. So I'm going to take the bearing now. Again, the same thing. You're going to see the notches. Just going to push down lightly. Make sure it's seated. And then again, you're gonna just take some assembly lube. I think I'm running low in this bottle, which I might have to, oh, there we go. I think I put too much. Just, again, you're gonna lube it up. Let me just grab a napkin here. And again, you're just gonna make sure that the notches are gonna match up. So I'm gonna put this right here. I'm gonna grab those two bolts that are the old bolts. Okay, I feel that one going in. I'm gonna do the same thing with this one. And then I'm going to grab my 3/8 ratchet with my 17 just to hand tighten it. And at certain points, you're gonna feel it get a little tight because it is going to be adjusting itself and getting on flat. I see the one side is on flat. Okay, this side's tight. Now, I'm just gonna take it off and do the same thing. 4 cylinders, 3 on. So these come back out. So now I'm gonna go to 3 again. Same thing, just make sure it lines up. Push it in, make sure that's seated properly. Get some assembly lube, coat her up. Again, making sure the notches line up. Remember, patience is everything. Something I don't have, but learning to have. Again, you're just going to use your ratchet. Just watching, usually my left side, which is your right side, is the one that has the side that's farther up than the right side. Okay, these are down. Now to come back up. Now to undo them. Hands slipping. All right. On to number four. This is in. Yes, I know I hold the ratchet wrong. It's just easier for me to hold it by the extension. It's my personal preference, so don't come for me. Okay, just want to make sure these are on properly. Just making sure I didn't mess up and put the one with the thrust cap on the wrong one. It's really important when you're taking the engine apart to label everything. So I don't know if you've seen, but on some of the caps we have T is for the thrust and then 7 is for the last cap. But it's just easier to do it that way so that we know exactly where everything goes and you don't get confused. Especially for me, since this is my first time learning how to do this stuff, makes it easier to see everything and remember where it goes. That way I don't forget, because I have short-term memory loss sometimes. Two more to go. Okay. So I'm gonna grab the thrust bearing now. Put it on the cap properly. Make sure I've got it lined up. All right. Grab some lube. Okay. And two. This way. I'm watching it from the inside, just making sure that it is properly seated, as I stated before. Now they're tight. And last but not least, number 7. Last bearing going in, snapped on in. Right. And I'm gonna do this way so you guys can see it better. And all 7 are now flat on their surfaces. Now I'm going to take these old bolts out. I'm going to put the new ones in and torque them down. All right, so as you just saw, I put the crank in and the main cap bolts, the main caps are on now and it's spinning freely. So now I'm going to be putting in the new bolts. These bolts are gonna be torqued down to 36.8 foot-pounds, and then I'm going to be putting them also 50 degree angle torque as well. First thing I'm gonna do is just, before I put them in, just oil them very lightly on some of the thread. And then I'm just gonna put it up by the head and then a little bit here, just very little. I'm gonna put these in first by hand, and then I'm gonna tighten them so that I don't have to waste a lot of time. Also, these are the brackets for the oil pickup tube. There's 2 of them. The first one's on cylinder 3 and the second one's on cylinder 5. Alright, I'm just gonna wipe my hands. So I'm just gonna tighten these by hand first, and then I'll use my snap-on to correctly get them torqued down. Good workout for your forearms. Feel the burn. Those are all tightened down. Hey guys, welcome back to another day of learning how to assemble an engine. Today we are going to be assembling the connecting rods, pistons, and bearings. I'm just gonna go over a few things that we have. Like I mentioned before, we are using the MAHLE PowerPak Pistons, standard bore, standard compression for this S54. In this kit, it also comes with the wrist pins, all the wrist pins you need, as well as the set of the three piston rings that you will also need. And then obviously I'm going to be using Carrillo connecting rods with the WMC bolts. So also, I forgot, we are going to be using King Race bearings as the connecting rod bearings. So yeah, I'm going to start showing you how to assemble them. I'm going to need someone to help me with the circlips for the wrist pins. So as you'll see shortly, you're gonna see someone helping me out to get these in because we do not have the proper tool, which is fine. You could just use your own at home or makeshift tool, as you'll see shortly. So yeah, let's get into it. All right, so I'm just going to take out the materials needed. So I have a piston here. I have a wrist pin here. I'm gonna take out connecting rod and have it all laid out so that I have everything needed to start assembling a piston rod. All right, so first things first, you're gonna take out a wrist pin, as you can see here. And there's those scraps over there. You're going to need two of these circlips. Connecting rod. And lastly, your pretty old piston. All right, so first things first, I'm just going to take a little bit of lube. Hopefully it doesn't come out too much. I'm just going to lube up the wrist pin. And I'm just going to grab a rag here. I'm going to put this up by its side first, because what you're going to take is, like I said, you're going to make your own tool. So I just grabbed a binder clip and I took off one of the sides. And basically what you're going to do is, there's a groove inside of this hole here where the wrist pin goes through, and you're just going to put the binder clip in there so that when you slide the wrist pin in and the connecting rod in, it holds it so that everything doesn't fall out for you. So I'm going to put this down here. I'm going to actually see the direction of this piston, which is facing forward. And I'm going to also make sure that the Carrillo is also facing forward. So if this is going to be over here, I'm going to make sure that Carrillo is also facing this way. So I'm going to slide this in. Now it's in, as you can see. Now I'm going to face it on this side, making sure that everything's the same. And now this is going to be the two-person job. So now I'm going to take one of these circlips, and I'm going to have one of my guys help me and hold the fingers down so that it stays in. So another thing to keep in mind is there's also this little tab here. So when you put in the circlip, you want it offset so that it doesn't get stuck when you're snapping it into place. So I'm just going to face this way now. And I'm going to have one of my guys help me. He's just going to hold it down while I try to get it in. I'm just using a screwdriver. The other thing that you want to make sure is you're not scoring the actual piston. You just want to use light pressure to make sure that you're getting the circlip in and pushing it forward, and you're going to see it snap in place shortly. Oh, the binder clip just snapped out. Just resetting that. All right, so as you see, there's the groove there, and we're just making sure that the circlip is facing the opposite direction. The opening of the circlip is in the opposite direction. And now the edge that's lifted up towards the back, towards the back of the piston, is the part that we're going to slowly push in. It's gonna take a few times. It's not gonna be the first time you hit it in that it's gonna go in. It does require a lot of patience. Ready? Looks like it snapped into place. I'm just going to show you really quick. So as you can see, the circlip, oh, it actually is not in place over here. There we go. Now it snapped into place, as you heard. So now you see it holding in there. And it's in. So now we're going to go to the opposite side, where now you could take out the binder clip. And we're going to do the same thing on this opposite side. And do the same thing again. You want to make sure that the opening of the circlip is opposite from the groove. And you're just going to put pressure with the thumb while at the same time you're pulling it slightly in. So both ends are in, but now the back side isn't in, so let me take it back out, and we're going to try it again. Like I said, it takes a lot of patience, so you're not always going to get it on the first try. Sometimes it takes 3-4 times to put it in. I'm going to try it again. And we're almost there, and I just have to tap it in now. Like I said, you just want to put light pressure to get it in place. And again, you see that both ends are in. And now we can start putting on the piston rings. All right, so now we're going to start assembling this piston rings. So MAHLE normally comes with this information guide that actually comes with the pistons, and it'll actually show you the proper ring installation. So this one has three rings, but the third bottom ring has two seals that go around, which I'll show you. It tells you actually the orientation, and it'll actually show you, and I'll show you now, the top and bottoms of them. So this one, like I said, has three of them, and it shows you this goes to the first, this goes to the second, this one that goes to the third. So I'm just going to open this up and place it here. The first one shows you here. So you can see there's no markings on this side besides this little M, which is the top side, which you might not be even able to tell because it's so tiny. So this top side has to be up when you put the piston ring on. So this is gonna go in like this. Sorry. All right, another thing is you're gonna want to make sure that there's a little bit of lube on it, just that it slides in better. You just want a little drop, and you're just gonna go like this around the ring, just to make sure that there is some lubrication on it. And remember, we want to find the M. So this is still up, and we are going to put this on this first rung here, and you're very lightly going to snap it into place. Again, lots of patience. This is not something you do in a rush. So now the first one's in, as you can see. There is a little bit of wiggle room, but you will see later that it's going to get compressed in and tightened. So that first one's done. And dropped my circlips. Now I'm going to go to ring number two. Again, you want to make sure that this, let me get a better one. This one's all scratched up. This one shows you, it says M top. Just want to make sure that's the right thing. It's so tiny. So you want to make sure that this is also placed in like this, because this is the top of the piston ring. Again, just a little bit of lube in your fingers all around. And now these two first rings are so much easier to put on than the bottom one, and you will see why. So again, you're just gonna slightly push down. You don't want to pull too much because you don't want to expand them too much. So this third one, and you just want to make sure you go around and get it in. So this third one's in now. So now we see all of them moving, right? All right. Last but not least, this is the worst one to put on because there's three in total. And as you can see in the instructions, you want to make sure that the middle seal is butted up like this, not like that, or the opposite way. So I'll show you by taking out these two. So this orientation does not matter for these seals because these are going to compress the jagged one. So those two are there, and then I'm just going to grab this one and show you really quickly what I mean by how it needs to lay. So this is not the way you want to put it. You want to make sure that it's right side up and that it sits like this inside. So first things first, I'm not going to lube this one up because this one's going to be more difficult, but these have a lot more play than the first two. So I'm going to put this one in first. Oh, this one just popped out too. And now as you see, we have the bottom one in. And the other thing you want to pay attention to is there is an orientation that needs to be done for the, oh, I think it's here. Yep, so here it shows you where all the rings need to be seated. So the bottom one I worry about first because those are, the three are harder to maneuver than the top two. So the bottom one is you want to make sure that the third ring is in the center. So basically I just align it right here. And then the other two need to be 90 to 100 degrees left and right. So I always just make sure that they're basically here. So you'll see me do that in a second. So now I'm just gonna take this one. And again, I'm just going to put this above. Oh, this one keeps popping out. Gonna put this above the bottom seal. And this one's a bigger pain in the butt to do because you have to slowly make sure that you're on the bottom of it or above it, whichever way you choose to do first. I just choose to do the bottom. And I like to push it and then kind of try and spin it because sometimes it falls into place. This one's just giving me difficulty right now. Some people have all tips and tricks for this, but I'm just gonna keep spinning it and hopefully it'll slide into place because that's what I did before. It's easier to do this when it's upside down, in my opinion. So, see, it's getting caught back here. If you look here, it's getting caught. So, let me take this out again and try recentering it. Okay. So, let me find the center. Let's try. Oh, wrong way. Gotcha. Again, you just need lots of patience for this. The other way you could do it, if you want, is you could put in the centerpiece, which I might end up doing first if this doesn't lay flat anytime soon. Or you start at the bottom ring and work your way up. All right, I'm gonna try getting this top one in now while I have it like this and see if it'll all just kind of slide into place. Again, it doesn't need to be perfect. You just want to make sure that they're just all in because you will be using the ring squeezer to set it all in and compress them. Oh, this one went a little too far. Okay, let's see if I spin it now, if it'll go in. Oh, this one is too high. There we go. It might be in now. Okay, so I'm just gonna check orientation of this. So this one, I'm gonna need to move this way. This one, remember, you want it towards the front. And then this one, trying to find the top. Oh, it popped back out again. This one needs to get pushed over. And I just popped it out. Like I said, it takes a few to get used to this. It's not easy. So I give props to people who work on these a lot. Let me see how I'm gonna remove this. Oh, popped back out again. Yep, All right, let me try going this way. Holding it. See, the first one I did, it basically went in, and all I had to do was rotate them. But this one seems to be a pain in the butt. I'm just going to grab a pick and see if I can move this top ring over very lightly. Because with my hands being oily, it's a little difficult. And I just knocked it out. See if I spin it, if it'll go in like it did last time. All right, this might be the best it's gonna get until I squeeze them in. Oh, I felt it go in. Okay, now we're too far with this one. All right, so this one's here, this one's here, this one's here. Now what you wanna do is make sure that the top two are opposite ends of each other. So if this is going to be the front, I'm gonna fix this in a few. This is going to be the front. This one's going to the back. So you want these two top ones to be opposite ends of each other, and then we're gonna compress it. So I'm gonna fix this off camera, and then I'm gonna show you how we're gonna compress it. I got a gal, she looked just fine. Always bring me whiskey and wine. Peppers in the morning and dinner at night. Everything she do just right. When I say what you want me to do, she say it just one thing that I want from you. A little bit of rock, a little bit of roll. A little bit of rock, ooh, a little bit of roll. A little bit of rock, a little bit of roll. Itty bitty little bit of rock and roll. We went to a dance, she was looking swell. Spinning around just like a carousel. Cutie bug boogie, swinging right. Having a ball on Saturday night. The band leader said, what you want us to play? The kids all how to just take it away. A little bit of rock, a little bit of roll. A little bit of rock, ooh, a little bit of roll. Well, a little bit of rock, a little bit of roll. Itty bitty little bit of rock and roll. She looked just fine. Always bring me whiskey and wine. Breakfast in the morning and dinner at night. Everything she do just right. When I say what you want me to do, she say just one thing that I want from you. A little bit of rock, a little bit of roll. All right, so we have the pistons done now with the rings on them. I'm just gonna show you the difference between a new piston and the stock piston. Right, so I'm gonna put this back down. Just gonna wipe my hand off. All right, so we already loosened the rod cap bolts. So I'm just gonna take them out so I didn't waste time doing that. And I'm gonna put them right here for now because I will clean them off. All just wipe my hands. I'm going to try to separate these. Okay, so now that I got this off, you just want to remember the orientation so that it goes back on. So I'm just going to leave that there for now. So the first thing I am going to do before I lube up the rings is I'm just going to clean the inside of the rod where the bearing is going to sit with some denatured alcohol. You could use any brand. This is the brand we have here. I'm just going to go like this. I'm going to clean this one too real quick. Ooh. So then the second thing you're going to do is you're going to, I already made sure all of my rings are properly seated. So the second thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to lube up all the rings as well as the wrist pin. Sorry, just had a blank inside here as well, so that it'll just be nice and easy to slide in. I'm just gonna run my fingers along this to make sure it is all lubed here and then here, and then I'm just gonna do this side as well. Just get my fingers in there, and then I did lube the one side, so I'm just going to lube over here and just slide it in. All right, so this is done now. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to set this down like this. I'm going to take two bearings that I have here, and I'm going to set this inside the rod. These also, I didn't show you guys this, but these also have a notch here, so you're going to just want to make sure that this notch lines in with the notch here in the rod. And you're just going to make sure that you have it evenly set, and then you're just going to push down and you should hear it click. Sometimes you just have to take it out and do it again because one side tends to sit higher than the other. So that one's in. I'm just gonna wipe my hands off. Same thing with here. You're going to make sure that the notch matches up with this. Make sure that they're evenly set and it's in place. So these are both set, so I'm just going to leave this here. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring you over to the block so I could clean the inside of the walls as well as the journal with some denatured alcohol. So I'm just gonna have my guy come over with the camera. Again, just some denatured alcohol. I already have two pistons already in, so I'm just gonna clean the walls before I squeeze the piston rings. And then I am going to try to rotate this so I can get the journal as well. I'm just going to take this and clean all around here really quick. You just want to make sure it's a clean surface. So I'm just going to go back around now. This is why I have trouble. Yes, I am super weak. All right, so now that I'm back, I'm going to have someone hold the piston for me and the rod so that I can squeeze it with the piston ring squeezer. Just need to stretch it out. I'm also going to get my ratchet with my extension. We're just going to tighten it so that it is properly set, and you basically just want it to be just a little below the lowest ring. And then what you're going to do is we're just going to tighten it. Just going to make sure my face isn't in the way. Most of the time you would have like a vice grip, but we do not have one here right now. And then the other thing you want to make sure is that it is level all the way around. Which pretty much looks level, so now we're just going to tighten it even more. Oh, go ahead. All right. So as you see, you want to just to make sure that this is the same on both sides. And then what we're going to do now is we're going to take it, we're going to bring it over to the block so that we can put it in and make sure that it's sitting level. So another thing is you want to make sure, like I said, there is an arrow here to show you that you want the piston to face the front of the block. So we're just going to put this in here. And let me grab a napkin because you just want to turn it. Oh, I forgot. So we're going to actually take this out real quick. We're going to rotate this to make sure. Before you put the connecting rod and piston in, you just want to make sure that the crank slash journal piece where the connecting rod is going to attach to is offset to the side so that you have access to it. Whether it's up or down, doesn't matter. That way you can connect the cap onto it. So the next thing that we're going to do is take the piston and the rod and also lube the center of this. Let me just get some lube before we do that. You're just going to lube. The inside walls. And you're just going to take your hand and go like this to make sure when you knock it in, it slides in. You just want to be careful also because the oil squirters are inside, so you don't want to hit any of that. All right. Now that I wipe my hand, you're going to take the piston and the rod. Again, here you want to make sure the arrow is facing forward and put it in like so. And make sure that this is straight. And then you're just going to take a rag and just lightly make sure that this is sitting flat. Because now when I go to hit it in, you want it to be as flat as possible. So I'm going to take a microfiber and I'm just going to put it inside here. I'm just going to put in the end of my mallet and I'm just going to give it a nice whack and hopefully it'll go through. All right, piston and rod are in. I'm going to put this to the side. Now what we want to do is flip this over. And I'm just going to show you here before I do anything because I need to put some assembly lube on the inside of the rod bearing. That is where the connecting rod and rod bearing are. I'm going to move it over here shortly, but like I said, I'm just going to take some assembly lube and get my fingers in there and wipe it all up on the rod bearing. You could do this before, I just did it now. And now you're gonna come back over here and do the same thing to the cap. You're just gonna tap some assembly lube on the inside. And you want to make sure get my flashlight, because it looks like we went a little too far with the crank and it's hitting. So let me grab a rag so I can move it a little bit. There we go. You want to put it this way, and then you could rotate it back a little. Now that that's there, I'm just going to make sure. All right, so what you want to do is you just want to make sure that you are guiding the rod onto the journal properly. You could either pull it from the inside, or you can go from underneath and push the piston down like I did. I just did it off camera. So now what I'm going to do first is I'm going to clean the rod bolts, because they are dirty, again, with just some denatured alcohol. They're not dirty, they just have assembly lube on them that come like that, but I'm gonna put some more on, and I just want to make sure that they're clean before I do so. Okay, so I have that there. I'm going to take the provided assembly lube from CP, and I'm just going to dab some here and here. Just gonna run my fingers around, and then do the same thing with this bolt. And dab it around. And then what you're going to do is you're going to take the cap, and you're just going to make sure it's in the proper direction, which goes like so. And you're gonna put it on. And you should feel it, I wouldn't say snap into place, but you should feel it sit in place. And then you're gonna take your bolt and start tightening it by finger. Same thing the other one. And for now, I'm gonna have to rotate this a bit because I can't get in there. There we go. For now, I'm just going to hand tighten these. I'm not going to torque them down to spec. I will do that later, but just to get them all in right now, that's what we're going to do. And then I'm also going to take just my ratchet. Make sure they're tightened just enough. Like I said, hand tight. As soon as I start to feel some resistance, like I did here, I'm just gonna stop. And just to check this one again. All right, both of them are tight, so that's the next piston and rod on. And I'm just going to spin it here. And I'm going to spin it also around just so you can see. So this is spinning freely. And now I'm going to spin it over. Oh, gosh. And do the same thing over here. So, cylinders 1, 2, and 3 are all rotating now. And yes, I did sign the first piston. All right, now I'm gonna go on to cylinder 4 and continue on.
Me cansé de relaciones, no quiero más prisiones. Por más que me critiquen, me tiene sin cojones. Papi, me puse mamá, mi lo sabe colón, me perre. Qué chimba se siente hacer el amor con otro y que quede entre nosotros. Tú eres mío sin papeles y así cero corazones rotos. Hacer el amor con otro.
hacer el amor con otro y que quede entre nosotros. Tú eres mío sin papeles, casi cero corazones rotos. Hacer el amor con otro y que quede entre nosotros. Tú eres mío sin papeles, casi cero corazones rotos.
Vamos a darnos estos tragos hasta el fondo. Si se filtra algún video, no le copio. De mi nota no respondo. Ese tío no es de España y está cachando. Hoy te quiero perrear y contigo sudar. No te puedo bloquear, yo me acabo de dejar. Dicen que él es loco, pero eso es mental. Él lo hizo primero, no se puede quedar.
Alright, so if you saw the previous video, you saw me install the old brackets for the oil pickup tube. I replaced them. I put on the new ones because we saw they were bent. And if you just take a quick look here, I'm gonna come forward. You can see that they're bent, so I just replaced them and put new ones in. They are genuine only, but now I'm going to torque down the main cap bolts. So the newton meters is 25, but converting into foot pounds, it is 18. So I have it set to 18. It's actually 18.4, so I'm just gonna go a little over and I'm gonna get started now. Should be fairly easy. It's done. Okay, all of those are torqued down now, so now I'm going to do the angle torque. All right, so now that the main caps are torqued down, I'm going to do the angle torque on the bolts now, which is 50 degrees. I'm just gonna use my torque wrench for it. I already have it set up and it's zeroing now. Just have to hold it still. All right, let me put it this way.
Port to reset, medium extension, or longer one, or longer extension. You can also use longer extension if you want to, for longer brackets, which I should do instead. See if you guys in here.
Now they're all torqued down to the correct foot pounds and torque angle. So we're gonna do the next thing. All right, so now the next thing is we're gonna be doing the joining torque and the angle torque on the rod bolts. So the joining torque on the rod bolts is going to be 18.4 foot pounds. And then the angle torque is going to be 7 degrees. So I'm gonna start on that now. So I already set my torque wrench up to 18 foot pounds. So now I'm just gonna start on it. So all of them are now done with the joining torque and the angle torque. All right, so I'm just gonna go over everything that I just did. So the main cap bolts as well as the rod bolts are both 18.4 foot pounds. The main cap bolts were torqued, angle torqued were 50 degrees, and then the rod bolts were torqued, angle torque was 70 degrees. Next thing I'm going to be doing is completing the bottom end. I'm going to be putting on the pickup tube as well as the oil pan, so stay tuned for that.